Erskine, you're fired.
Why, Mr. Wood, what is wrong?
You! Well, it is your idea we come up to this forsaken hole over the weekend. If I die of pneumonia, it'll be your debt to society.
Mr. Wood, I tried to be a competent secretary, but I have absolutely no control over the elements. How did I know it was going to rain? See, the paper says fair and warmer.
That's last week's paper. You're still fired. How much further do we go?
Won't be long now, Mr. Wood.
Well, it better not be.
Something the matter?
I guess we're stuck.
You guess you're stuck? What are you trying to do? Kill me?
Oh, no, it's not as serious as that. We just skidded into a fallen tree.
Don't stand there. Don't stand there like a pain seal. Suggest something.
I'm sorry, sir, but I never did work well underwater.
I know this part of the country intimately. There are several houses nearby. We can walk to one of them.
Swim, you mean?
I see a light down that way.
You couldn't see a light if you looked at the forest fire.
Mr. Ames.
Oh, hello, Caraway. I'm sorry. I didn't recognize this as Dr. Kent's house.
Just a moment, Ames. I don't know who this Dr. Kent is, but I'm getting out of the storm even if it's to be the missing link.
Yeah. Coming in, Mr. Ames.
Ames. Well, this is a surprise. Good to see you.
Yes, I suppose it is a surprise. We skidded off the road, hit a tree, and became mired in mud, and yours is the nearest house. Oh, pardon me, Dr. Kent. This is Herman Wood, the famous theatrical producer. You no doubt have heard of him, even if you haven't met him.
Delighted, Mr. Wood. You're courageous to face the storms we have up here.
Courageous. Well, I was looking for you.
Ridiculous. I hate cowards. When we get back to town, remind me to fire you.
Let the play continue.
Now that the play is over, I'll have to tell Wood what's happened.
Here he comes now.
Ha! Still making merry, I see. Well, we thought we'd come down again. It's too quiet upstairs for us.
Yes, we're used to shrieks, sirens, and suicide.
Yeah. Why, what seems to be the trouble? Hasn't Miss Beatrice been found?
Yes, she has been found. Dead.
Is that so? No, I mean, it can't be, it's impossible. What are you talking about?
Mr. Wood, I'm trying to tell you that Beatrice is dead.
Beatrice is dead? I don't believe it.
Let's put this whole thing straight to you, Mr. Wood. We're all actors, hired by Ames here to present his play to you.
Actors?
Everything that's happened since you arrived was part of the play.
Except for Beatrice's death.
Mr. Ames, am I to understand that I've been witnessing part of the play you were to read to me?
Yes, I thought it a good method of presenting it to you. You see, this is really my house, and the fallen tree on the road was all part of my scheme to fool you. The storm, of course, was an added break.
Well, if these chills and frills have been theatricals, where does the death of Beatrice fit in? Surely you don't destroy your characters.
Somebody evidently does.
We don't know any more about it than you do.
The police should be notified.
Now, wait a moment, everyone, please. I know that this is even more confusing to Mr. Wood than it is to us. He still believes we're putting on the play. So the only thing we can do is to show him Beatrice.
By all means, do.
Yes, death is no novelty to us.
No.
We stage it 8 times a week, including matinees.
And benefits.
Now, remember, no one is to touch the body until the police arrive. In there. Yes, go to bed, Mr. Wood, and get some sleep. You insist the play is still on, but we've tried to tell you that it's ended in a tragedy. Good night, sir.
Good night, Miss Lorraine.
Good night. Ames?
Good night.
Be sure and let us know if anyone else is murdered.
I can't convince those fools. They insist we're still playing for their benefit.
Oh, I wish we were out of this dreadful house. First it was Carrie pestering me, and now this awful tragedy of tonight.
Well, don't worry, dear. You look all worn out. You get some sleep, and I'll see that nothing disturbs you.
Oh, I'm too frightened to sleep. Tell me the truth. Who do you think could have killed Beatrice, and where do you think she could be?
Well, personally, I believe it was just a burglar who's long since disappeared.
Then why would he steal the body?
Oh, to cover up the crime, I suppose. Now you go to bed, dear.
Hey, Gloria. What is it?
Oh, you poor kid, your nerves have completely gone.
Oh, it's you. I ought to pull the trigger at that. Well, come on, snap out of it. What is it?
Mr. Wood, maybe we're wrong. Maybe this isn't the play we're witnessing after all.
Oh, rubbish. You saw the manuscript, didn't you?
Yes, but I didn't see anything in it about the top of my bed coming down and smothering me just like a steak under onions.
Oh, nonsense. You've had too many cocktails. Besides, I wouldn't be lucky enough to celebrate your demise by violence.
That's a fine way for you to talk to me. Me, who's been everything to you but a mother. Now, Mr. Wood, listen to reason. I may be all wrong. I'm a nervous man by nature. But if this play is still going on, it's the closest thing to reality I ever saw behind the footlights.
Oh, you're a sissy. I tell you, this fellow Ames is clever. He has reality in his play, and that's what the public wants. Now, let me alone. And if you want to stay in the theatrical business, stop letting it scare you.
Oh, I was kidding all the time. That bed bracket was only a dream I had. And you were in it, too.
I was not. I was reading.
Yes, I saw that. You were reading a book on psychics. You were worried about the future yourself.
Say, go home and go to bed, will you, please? And if you want to think of the future, remember I'm firing you.
Mr. Wood, I have a premonition that we must stick together tonight. You need protection.
You mean you do? You're trying to muscle into my bed because you're frightened. Go home.
Oh, my dear employer, play or no play, I have no relish for my own couch. Move over.
Say, this is all tommyrot. You've got the mind of an oyster and the nerve of an acrobat. As my secretary, I do allow you to share my office, but that does not include my bed. Hey. You were born in October, weren't you?
Yes, during the National Apple Week. Why?
It says here, your type is the instincts of a bloodhound, the heritage of the homing pigeon, the attributes of the ferret, and the heart of a lion. Lion. I'm sleeping in a zoo.
know I love you. Why do you always give me the cold shoulder?
I'm just not interested, Terry. Why did you come here? It makes it very embarrassing.
Oh, I know. You're afraid your playwright's sweetheart would be jealous if he knew I was here. Well, I wish he could see you now. I just came in to say goodbye. I'm walking out on this play, but I've got a curtain speech to make, and this is it.
Stop, Terry!
Are you fool? Now see what you've done. I'll hide in that closet until he goes. If you tell him I'm here, I'll say you invited me.
Man.
Well, where was he?
He came in that door. I screamed and he went away.
Oh, you poor kid. What a narrow escape you had.
I wonder what that screaming was about.
There's a light in Gloria's room. Let's see what's up.
You take it easy. I'll find the guard. We'll search the house again.
What's happened? We heard screams.
Someone tried to break into Gloria's room.
What? Who?
I don't know.
Here comes the guard.
Seen anything?
Plenty. Gloria was almost attacked by someone.
Fancy that.
Who do you think it was?
I don't know.
We'll wake up everybody and find out.
Good idea. Let's try Terry first.
Oh, Terry.
He's gone.
Not a sign of him.
Whose room is this?
Well, that's mine. And there's Erskine's room, and that's Mr. Woods.
Well, let's see what they know.
Empty.
Darn the luck. I wonder if that maniac could have tried Woods' room before my mind snaps too.
Eh?
Oh.
Hey, you two.
Get out of here. My office hours are from 10 to 4.
Seen anything strange in here?
Yes. Here's an exhibit that ought to be in a museum.
What are you doing in here?
I was sleeping. Is the play on again?
No. We're just having a roll call.
Well, consider us absent.
Terry. Terry, come out.
Boys, I'm going to retire from now for the second time tonight. Ames, go on with your rehearsal, but don't disturb me for the finale. And again I say, good night!
Please continue. I never walk out on anything that doesn't cost me something.
What does he mean?
Oh, these fools think we're putting on a play for their benefit.
I'm hungry.
I could destroy a few vitamins myself.
Well, you'll find some food in the kitchen. I'll be waiting for you here.
Come in.
Mr. Woods and gentlemen to see you.
Have you seen Gloria?
She doesn't seem to be here. Why?
Gloria has been kidnapped.
Goody, goody.
I say, that's beastly rude of you.
They accused me, but I think Teddy's the guilty one. He's gone, too.
They've got to search the whole place over again. Get up and see the fun. It's better than looking for a good candidate before an election.
Not me. I'm staying right here. Now, if they don't stop this fool play and get out of here, I'll rid the world of the entire cast.
All right, stay here. I hope you're the next victim.
And Mr. Wood, could I have a word with you?
If you try to get in this bed again, I'll shoot you, so help me.
ready for a presentation now that will astound the world.
I believe you are. I'll bet you'd be a sensation and a good part. And I'm going to give it to you. Herman Wood, the man who has given more stars to Broadway than Edison has electric lights, will star you personally in an extravaganza.
Splendid, splendid.
Oh, are you busy Thursday?
Let me see. No, I have nothing planned.
Good. Come to my office next Thursday and we'll sign a contract.
Splendid. But you should see me work first.
Well, what are you doing now?
Wasting time talking to you. Come with me, and I will show you real dramatics.
Are you kidding?
I never joke. I will show you drama. Stark, throbbing drama with a master touch of comedy.
By golly, I'm with you. Just wait till I get my slippers.
Don't forget, Thursday. Come.
I'd feel a lot safer if I had my gun.
Where is it?
Home.
That's okay with me. Let's go over to your house and hang around.
It'll soon be daylight. Thank heaven. Ames. Anything new?
We made a complete search of the grounds and found nothing.
Well, how much longer is this going on? I'm getting tired of sitting around here and waiting for something that doesn't happen. I missed the picture. It's alive. It winked.
What's the matter with him?
He must be balmy.
To you.
Remember when I left the house to get the car and the cops?
Yes.
Well, that nuthouse guard leaves me at the garage. Then just as I'm getting into the car, somebody slugged me with a lead pipe.
What was the idea? Well, someone didn't want him to get away. And that someone is probably the escape nut that we're looking for.
How many of you are searching for him? There's already been a guard here tonight.
Well, there's possibly half a dozen of us. But Glevy and I'll find him.
Yeah, this guy disappears every so often. But we always spot him in this neighborhood.
I see. Well, after you were hit on the head, why did you come back to the house?
I figured getting the police was the wisest move to make. I'd been knocked out and tied in the garage, but I broke the ropes. Then I tried to start the car, but I found out someone had gummed up the motor. Well, I began to hoof it into the village when these guards from the sanitarium picked me up, and here we are. Has anything happened since I left?
Yes, Gloria's been kidnapped and Terry's disappeared.
And now that Erskine person's gone violent.
Oh, yeah? Well, I'll handle that.
Help! Help!
What's the matter?
I will be more careful to see that you don't suffer the accidental death she did. I have brought back the spark of life. I am colossal.
Oh, my headache. Take that smelling salts away. You're choking me.
I am awfully embarrassed. I thought I killed you, but I only gave you a headache. I ask your indulgence in looking at this chart. You will notice the various noses, eyes, and chins. You all have an ideal, a face you envy. You can have your choice of alteration. You understand, my operations run in series. You may look as you wish now. Ultimately, I will slowly change you to fit my model.
My, we'll return at once. Poor Caesar must be miserable.
Oh, Kreska, take me out of here. I never want to see another horror play.
Well, don't worry. I'll never write another one.
Yes, you will.
What?
Absolutely, but you've got to rewrite it. Just like this night and the experiences we've gone through.
Even to the murder of Beatrice?
Yes, I'm afraid Beatrice will have to die all over again.
Well, the ghost walks after all.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, John.
You were all right, too, Carraway.
Thank you, Mr. Wood.
Now, what's the matter with you?
I was just thinking how terrible it would have been had the professor really operated on us and changed us all. You might have gotten my adenoids, and I would have gotten your false teeth.
Erskine. Turn your face to the setting sun.
Oh! What's the idea?
Don't forget, you're fired.
Oh, Mr. Wood.
Come.